we are here to discuss very serious issues that are affecting us, and I believe those are basically oriented towards the legal aspect. We would also want to understand that the board does not operate alone. It has stakeholders in the industry, and we try to reach out. And I believe for the last 3 years or so, we've been able to do that quite effectively. I'm happy to even say that the Kenya National Qualifications Authority, which is at the, almost a new kid on the block, is here with us. I'm happy to report that even the universities that are upcoming and want to offer architecture and quant surveying, we've been in contact together with them, together with the old institutions. So for us, is we are trying to reach out so that we can make practice and the industry a better place to do our business.
Chairman of Borax, ladies and gentlemen, it's indeed my pleasure to come and share with you this morning. I was told to come and eat breakfast. I didn't know I was going to stand on a podium at this hour with prominent men like the two tough men lawyers we have been with for a long period of time. But nevertheless, what we are here for is a very good cause. So indeed, high time we finalize this document. The document has been in the offing for several years, I can't count. Because I remember from the time Sika was the chairman of the board, we were in Naivasha, all the way we came up. We went one time to KIA, we had some good resolutions. Everything has its own time. Maybe this time had not come. There are so many acts of parliament which have been passed, which we must reflect how they affect us. There are many, many things, planning, urban cities, devolution was not there that time. Maybe it is the right time now to make it very modern. So let's do some adjustment, make it work better. We have a new constitution, we have a new dispensation. So we must be up to the task. Make it as modern and long-lasting as possible. With consultations like this, I think we have somewhere to go.
I would wish to invite our consultant, Jeremiah Dobby, who is going to take us through.
For those of you whom I haven't met, my name is Jeremiah Dobby. I'm a specialist in legislation draft. Legislative drafting. This bill that you have before you, the Built Environment Bill, a practitioner bill, what is a bit striking about it is it's a bit novel. You will find it a bit novel. It tries to strike so many balance. In the process of drafting it, I had to think outside the box. I had to think of the players themselves. So whatever is here, give and take. Try not to destroy it. Because it's delicate, you know, constructing life, constructing a plant, constructing a building, delicate balance. The same thing with law. There is no perfect law. So you'll allow me to run through the draft, cloud by cloud. That will enable you even to see the objective. Just in summary, I know the objective was, first, you'll find a lot of clauses drafted in conformity with the new constitution. Secondly, you will find a lot of clauses drafted in conformity with the profession, the evolving profession and the conflicts that are there. Thirdly, fourth, you will find the draft again has provisions to strengthen a CAP 525. You remember the whole CAP 525 was an amendment bill. It was trying to bring CAP 525 up to be in consonance with the other laws. But now this is much, much better. It has moved way away from that.
It's now my pleasure to invite Dr. Architect Susan Kibue, who will lead us in the next session, is a suggestion, question and answer session.
I don't know how is the best way to go, whether we go in sections or I don't know what's the best way to go, whether we take it in parts. I think maybe we could go in parts is better. Yeah, we can go in parts. We tackle issues within the different parts as outlined in the bill. Yeah, because I think it will be more coordinated and more organized for our consultant to take notes and also for our rapporteur. So I think we can kick off, so please, we can start having comments immediately. I'll start with you, yes, please.
What I know the most is the title, the Built Environment Practitioner Bill. I don't know whether you are aware that we have a Built Environment Bill, which has been ongoing from 2009. That's why my unit is the youngest, and it has gone quite a bit. That's
Parliament come back again
in the cabinet for refining, and then go about the chief. This one is actually dealing with the youth
environment. Most architects and professionals work, but they never earn their fees. They are not paid. How can that be addressed in this process? All the bills which I see, even the built environment bill, now professionals bill, NCA and the rest of them, none of them addresses the issue of our client. Okay. How should clients or developers be regulated in light of all these bills that are coming up?
What I would like to see is how this bill is going to enable, for instance, the board to rein in on errant developers who either do not intentionally consult the professionals they require to consult when they are doing their projects.
We acknowledge your presence, and when we invite you next time, please come and participate again in such a meeting, because at the end of the day, we need an harmonized document which will be able to put us together as architects and conservators, and be able to provide the necessary and required services to this country. May God bless each one of you, and thank you once again.